Hello and welcome to this PSTrace tutorial video. I'm Lutz Stratmann and today I'm going to talk about stripping voltammetry. Let's first talk about what is stripping voltammetry. Maybe you just clicked on the video because you like our tutorial videos and you don't know yet what stripping voltammetry is. In general, stripping voltammetry means that you're depositing some material on your electrode and then via voltammetry remove that layer again from your electrode and you detect the removal and use that for quantification or, well, also qualitative analysis. There are two ways of stripping voltammetry that are common. One of them is just take your electrode and rub it on the material that you would like to analyze. So this is, I think, only really qualitative, but maybe there's like normalized rubbing and everything. Because I'm an electrochemist, the way I usually do it is the other one, and that is electrodepositing this material on my electrode. So that means usually you apply for a defined amount of time, a very cathodic potential, and this way accumulating, for example, metal, heavy metals from a solution. So you have heavy metal ions in the solution, and when they get in contact with the very cathodic polarized electrode, they get reduced. And you should choose an electrode where these metal nicely stick on the electrode. There are, of course, also other ways of doing stripping voltammetry and depositing different materials. There's also something where you do an anodic deposition and a cathodic stripping. But for this example, I'm staying with cathodic deposition and then anodic stripping. So we're collecting heavy metals on the electrode, and then we're doing some kind of voltammetry where we sweep the potential to more anodic potentials, where we then strip off the electrode again. So first we dress it by electrodeposition, and then the electrode strips for us during the voltammetry. This is a technique that's very useful because that deposition is a pre-concentration step. And this way you can detect, for example, even traces or ultra traces of heavy metals in water. Now I would like to talk about how to do it. And before we go to PSTrace, I would just like to show you the setup that I've chosen for today. So I've connected my PalmSens 4 via Bluetooth to my computer. I have connected via the auxiliary port of the PalmSens 4 the switchbox. And that switchbox is connected to the power supply of that stirrer. Now I can control with the potentiostat the stirrer. Let's now have a look at PSTrace, how to do it there. Sometimes people are a bit confused because they read on our website that they can do stripping voltammetry with our software, but they don't see in the techniques list a dedicated technique for stripping voltammetry. Well, that is because you can actually turn any of our techniques into a stripping technique. So you can choose your favorite one. So popular techniques for stripping voltammetry are linear sweep, square wave voltammetry, or differential pulse. So let's stick with square wave voltammetry. If I reduce these parts, this looks exactly like a normal square wave voltammetry you would do. And then you put your settings here for the stripping step, and that's all the usual things that you do. But now the thing that you do extra is you also go into the pre-treatment settings, because for the stripping, you need to apply a potential for deposition to first get your electrode dressed. But also, it's common to apply a conditioning potential to first maybe strip off old remains from your electrode or maybe reduce the surface of your electrode to get it back into an initial state. So this is what we can do here. We have here an E condition that we can enter, for example, minus 1.1 volts. Then we have a T condition, that is the time where E condition is applied, here 5 seconds. Then we have an E deposition, and that is now the potential where we want to deposit whatever is in our solution that we want to analyze. And the T deposition is the time where we apply the E deposition. That is actually all we need to do, and we already have a stripping technique. This would be enough. You think, okay, we're done, but I would like to show you two more things that are handy for doing stripping voltammetry. One of them is the stirrer that I have connected to my setup. For stripping voltammetry, it's very common that during the deposition step, you have a stirrer so that as much solution as possible gets in contact with your electrode and you can deposit a lot of heavy metal. How to use the stirrer? Well, we've explained it in a separate video, but just here's a quick recap. You just go to Tools, General Settings, you choose Stirrer is present. and you choose the stereo with the switch box. Then you open peripherals here and choose use stereo. Okay, this way the stereo will be used, and that means the stereo will be on in the conditioning step and in the deposition step. It will switch off during the measurement because then you don't want to have convection. You also only want to have diffusion, so all your theory matches with your measurement. Then a last thing that I find important for stripping voltammetry, especially if you use sensitive surfaces, like for example a mercury surface. So for example, the ItelSense heavy metal electrodes that we have a mercury thin film. There it's important that after the measurement you keep the cell on so you can keep the electrode polarized at a potential that the mercury thin film doesn't get destroyed. You can do that here just by switching that switch box, but for the sake of that demonstration, I will switch this off so the cell will switch off after the measurement. Let's look how that measurement looks like. So I start the measurement, the stereo switches on, and as you know, I've set the two position and conditioning potentials for 5 seconds each. So after 10 seconds, the stereo will stop. Then it takes 5 seconds equilibration time and the measurement starts. And of course, I'm just measuring noise. I've not connected any electrodes to the potentiostat because this is just for the sake of the software demonstration. So this is everything that I wanted to show you today. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on LinkedIn so you don't miss any updates when we post new videos. We also already have a collection of videos on our website. You can find a link for that in the description below. So thanks for watching. And have a great day.